In this video, we're going to take a look at the bill of materials of an Autodesk Inventor assembly. I'm in an assembly. I'm going to go to the Assemble tab and the Manage panel and select Bill of Materials. That will bring up this Bill of Materials dialog box, which has three different tabs. We have Model Data, Structured, and Parts Only. It may be necessary to right-click on any of these tabs and enable that particular tab. The Model Data tab presents the information of this assembly very similar to the model browser. I have the different assemblies. I can expand them to see all of the sub-assemblies and parts that comprise that assembly. On the Structured tab, I just simply have all of the different assemblies, and then the parts only, just as it says. I don't see the sub-assemblies, I see just all of the parts. The bill of materials is basically a database of information of all the parts and assemblies that are in this particular assembly. Most of the information that you're going to see here is coming from the eye properties of the different parts and assemblies. There are several different ways that we can adjust our bill of materials. One thing that we can do is turn an assembly into a phantom assembly. So I'm going to double click on this normal structure here for this one and set it to phantom. What that does is it basically promotes all of the parts to first level items inside the bill of materials. As you can see, it doesn't actually adjust the assembly itself. It's just inside of the bill of materials. Another change that I can make is I can turn something into a purchased part. So I'm going to do that to the cylinder. After doing so, when I go to the Parts Only tab, no longer does it list all the individual parts of the cylinder. It just lists the overall cylinder, since that is a purchased item. Another thing that we can do is add virtual components. This would be for things like grease that are part of the assembly, but is not something that we would actually model. I'm going to select the Create option, and then I will give this a name. Again, in this case, I'll call it Grease. And then I'm going to select Virtual Component, and it's going to be a purchased item. Then I will click OK. We can actually see this over here in the model browser now. You can see the different icon indicating that it is a purchased item. I can adjust its settings by right-clicking on it and choosing Component Settings. And then I will select the button here to open up the parameters dialog box. I'm going to add a numeric parameter here, and I'll call this one base quantity. For the unit type, I'll put in ml for milliliters, and then I'll set it to 1 milliliter by default. Then I'll select done. Then I'll close this dialog box here. I'll go ahead and reopen my bill of materials. And as I scroll to the bottom, I'm going to see the grease item here now, and I can adjust the quantity of this item. We can also adjust the columns that show up here. I'm going to choose my column chooser button here. And if there's any columns I don't want, I can simply drag and drop them into this customization dialog. And then if there's any I do want, such as company, I can actually drag and drop that out onto my screen. Then I can go ahead and close this dialog. I can go ahead and adjust the information here. So I'm going to enter in a company name for my cylinder. Then I'll select done. I'm going to save my assembly. Notice that it's going to save any components that were adjusted, including the cylinder. I'm going to right-click one of these cylinders and open it. Then I will get into its eye properties. As you can see, the company information has been filled in here. So once again, the bill of materials is basically a database of all the information. You could adjust information there and it will populate into the separate parts and sub-assemblies. I'm going to open up the bill of materials one more time, and this time I'm going to export this information. I'm going to select the first button here, Export Bill of Materials. I can decide which tab I want to export. I'll go ahead and select Parts Only, and then click OK. And then I can go ahead and give this a name. I'll call this my arm system Bill of Materials, then click Save. I could then open up the exported file in a spreadsheet so I have a different way to take a look at the information. That concludes this look at the Bill of Materials tool in Autodesk Inventor.